Okay.
Oh my god.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's bright and early here.
It's very, it's very early.
Please allow us to awake. We have a cup of tea.
We've got a big day ahead and we have to film in the morning. Because we simply need to be listening to this song.
But we also need to be capturing
our reaction to it.
Yeah, oh, absolutely, yes.
So here we are, early in the morning in Australia.
Ready to listen to this. We already know it's going to be a masterpiece.
Look.
I'm scared.
Here's some things I've read slash heard.
Yes. Okay, me too. I've read a few things.
Yes, because...
It's kind of hard not to read.
It's very hard not... Yeah. It's just very hard to just not even say... And then you don't even know that it's about the song until you get to the point where you know that it's about the song.
Yeah.
So it's like one of those things. It's featuring Taylor Swift, but it's mostly Taylor Swift.
I've heard the same. Yep.
Yeah. It's offensive.
It's offensive. It's rude.
Apparently.
Yeah. I read one thing that said it gives me long story short vibes, and that's overwhelming.
That's a lot to say. I think from what I've seen as well, it might be like a toxic relationship vibe, or a relationship breakdown.
Okay. Yeah. Name is Renegade.
Yes.
And what does that even mean?
I actually don't know. Let's look up the definition of renegade.
Please.
A person who deserts and betrays an organization, country, or set of principles. So I'm guessing
she feels betrayed? And that has such exile energy. Remember when we looked up exile?
True.
Oh my god, I'm scared. I'm scared.
Same. Okay, so in Aaron's post about the song, I think he wrote the track, Taylor wrote the lyrics, Bonniver then brought that culmination to another level.
Oh, as he does.
As he does.
As if you can even already elevate Taylor Swift and Aaron. He somehow does.
It's honestly just like, it's offensive to have another song by these three.
It is.
Because obviously
so excellent.
None of us are well after Folklore and Evermore.
No. And I feel like this is the perfect way to do it because we actually can't survive another album.
No, no. So, not yet anyway.
Not yet anyway. Please, don't do it to me.
Yeah, don't.
But giving us just two songs on an album is great. And the fact that they're still making music and that they're doing this whole collaborative group thing is just so cool, and they're bringing in other artists as well on this record.
Yeah.
And it's just I'm excited to listen to the whole album. And
so look, it's basically just a Folklore Evermore song.
That's what I'm expecting.
Too. Oh my god, I'm so excited.
So overwhelmed because that's
so
excited. Especially because when she was she did that interview after Evermore, she was we were still writing after Folklore, we didn't know if it was going to be Big Red Machines What do you mean?
Here we are. Then we got Evermore, and now we got this.
Yeah.
We got two songs on this album too.
I know. And
which
is this the track 5?
I think it is.
I think it is. Yeah.
I think it is.
How illegal that she's got the track 5. I just love little things like that. She's like, I'll have track 5.
I can't deal with her doing that. As I swallow.
Emily's not the most well right now,
It's not COVID.
Just keep it. No, it's not COVID, but she's not well, so just keep that in mind. Okay.
I'm sorry if I don't sound as loud.
Oh my god, I'm so excited. She's going to say some deeply iconic.
Isn't it just it's a lot to listen to a new Taylor Swift song and know
she's going to say some deeply iconic things. We're getting a new Taylor Swift song.
I think there's going to be some lyrics in this song that...
I'm not ready.
...are going to fuck us up.
I'm scared. This is a life-changing moment.
It actually is a life-changing moment.
We can have... Today we get a whole fucking new Taylor Swift song.
I know, and we get to listen to it all day.
Oh, and then forever! Forever!
From this moment, we have added another Taylor Swift song. Are we ready?
Yeah, ready.
Oh my god, wait. Before we start, I simply need to just be saying some things. This bitch. This bitch uploaded a picture on her Instagram and she said photo by James Reynolds.
Is that Ryan Reynolds'
brother? No, it's James, their daughter. James, Betty James. And Inez.
Wait, I'm so
overwhelmed.
Oh my god.
How dare she look like that? How dare James take that picture?
Oh, I was just thinking, that dress, absolutely offensive.
Oh,
that
I simply want that dress.
Can't believe you just discovered that. I was like, James? Ryan Reynolds?
James Reynolds?
Is that his brother?
James.
James.
It's the James.
Wow. Okay.
Okay. I'll start again.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
I'm getting my cheese ricochet vibes right here.
Yeah. I tapped on your window on your darkest night. The shape of you was jagged and weak. There was nowhere for me to stay, but I stayed anyway. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. I get the long story short vibes immediately. I get it.
Like that tapping and it goes... How dare it go pick up that quickly?
Oh, my God. What the hell did she just speak to us? Sorry. I tapped on your window on your darkest night. The shape of you was jagged and weak. There was nowhere for me to stay.
What if that melody was offensive?
Literally.
There was nowhere for me to stay, but I stayed anyway.
I think that's all we're up to.
Oh, my God. That's like, that reminds me of I stayed here, you know, dust collected on my pinned up hair. The context, not the same, but just that one lyric.
Yes, I get.
There was nowhere for me to stay, but I stayed anyway. Does she mean like physically there was nowhere for her to stay? Or does she mean like... there was no space for her, like, emotionally,
in the relationship. But I stayed anyway.
The guitar was so offensive. Did you hear that? And amongst...
I know. If I would have known how many pieces you had crumbled into, I might have let them lay. She had like understood the magnitude of how
fucked up this person
was.
Yeah.
She would have left.
Yes.
Basically, she wouldn't have stayed.
That's some relatable lyrics right there.
Simply need a drink.
Yes. This is the best song I've ever heard.
It'd be like that.
It'd be like that. Are you really gonna talk about town in times like these? Let all your damage me. Carry your baggage up my street. Make me your future history. It's time you come along. Open the blinds, let me see your face. You wouldn't be the first renegade.
Another example of like, I thought Taylor Swift had already explained every scenario and every emotion.
She hasn't.
And now this bitch is like, oh no, you have baggage and you fucked me up because of it.
Yes. Oh, this, we've never had this.
We haven't had this.
Oh, this is so good.
Wait.
I'm so overwhelmed.
Are you really going to talk about timing in times like these and let your baggage damage me and carry your baggage up my street?
Oh, that's
and
a
make
one.
Me your future history. It's time.
And make me your future history.
Wait, have we? I don't think we finished the chorus. I'd just like to say this is relatable.
Yeah, this is relatable. This is very relatable. I can't believe she's managed to put these words together.
Right.
Is it insensitive for me to say, get your shit together so I can love you? Hello. Wow. That's the most relatable lyric she's ever written.
What about that next one?
Is it really your anxiety that stops you from giving me everything?
Or do you just not want to? So sorry.
I don't know. Just I love her talking about mental health and anxiety.
Yeah.
And like bringing that more into songs. Because like obviously she's talked about heartbreak so many times, but I feel like she's getting more complicated in like the mental health realm.
Yeah. And it's really interesting because I feel like she has like mostly sung and spoken about mental health issues like from a very like empathetic understanding way.
Yes.
But this is really like actually calling out like, do you know what? Like this is kind of calling out...
It's
the people who are kind of fucked up but refuse to
acknowledge it
and get help they need,
yeah.
And they're damaging the people around
absolutely
them.
Yes,
and it's toxic. Taylor.
Oh my God. I've never heard her write this, obviously.
No.
But it's just like, it's just so fucked up. Like you said, like she just keeps writing like such specific examples of things that you didn't know you needed until she wrote it. This is amazing. Oh my God. I'm scared for the future of this song.
The future of this song. Okay.
Okay, so that first part of that verse was the same as the second verse, but then she came in with some new lyrics about what the fuck did she just say?
You fire off missiles because you hate yourself, but do you know you're demolishing me?
Oh my God, this is just so fucking great. Like,
these lyrics are fucked.
She's painting like the perfect relationship where like someone has mental health issues or anxiety and they don't give their partner their needs or they don't meet their needs.
Yeah.
And they destroy themselves and they destroy everyone around them.
Yeah.
And it's so hard to be on the receiving end of that because you want to be empathetic of their issues, but you also know that your needs are not being met. And she's like somehow.
You feel like a bad person for like maybe not being understanding. Like even the way that she said, is it insensitive of me to say, get your shit together so I can love you? It's like, it's like, I don't want to leave, but like also...
But like, also this is not it. Like I can't keep doing this.
No,
I can't giving from an empty cup.
Yes.
Oh.
Also, the next lyric, and then you squeeze my hand as I'm about to leave, reminds me of New Year's Day, obviously.
Oh, yes.
But like,
but
not.
But also in a toxic way. Relationship. Yeah. It's like they finally show up a little bit when you're actually going to leave.
But that's it. That's exactly what you would get out of a person like this.
Yes.
Is a squeeze on the hand. It's like
it's absolute bare minimum. Yeah.
But like it gives you enough to be like, oh, maybe they do want me here.
They do really want me here.
Uh-huh.
And like sometimes those sides come through of them, but the squeeze of the hand is such a perfect thing because it's not really that much. It's not like they're saying anything or a gesture or anything. Like it's just a little something to keep you there.
Uh-huh. The fact that she was able to just write that and sum that up, what?
It's actually completely illegal that she does these things.
What do you mean?
Are you guys just like, I just like live in a permanent state of fear because like she just
it's
keeps,
a permanent state of
she
fear.
She just keeps, she's just gonna keep doing this. Has anyone thought about that? Like she just keeps doing this and like she can't write a bad song.
She can write.
Wait, isn't
like
it just
this?
So funny that like she thought like Bonavir like wouldn't want to work with her?
And oh, and now like, Bonavir is like, I only want to work with you.
Oh my God, can we talk about his offensive backing vocals in the chorus? Oh my God, I think we're about to go back into that.
Yes, we are. And they're like, they're kind of like the exile. It's the exile voice. It's not the.
Oh, it's not the.
It's not the common Bonavir
no,
voice.
No, it's
that
still that
we
deep.
All know.
That deep backing vocal. Down that lyric, you wouldn't be the first renegade to need somebody.
Well, it's like I feel like someone in this state of mind, like super mentally unwell, like and is not meeting the needs of their loved ones around them, and is like just very absorbed in like their own sort of like mental health issues.
Yeah.
But also refusing help.
Yeah.
It's like I feel like she's kind of saying like it's okay for you to need someone, but you've push me away.
Yes. Yes.
Like, because everyone needs someone.
Yes.
But I feel like, I mean, that is my personal experience is that a person that is in this frame of mind pushes people away if they're not ready to face their issues.
Yes.
And they forget that they need someone.
Yes.
They forget that they can actually let people in. You need to let them support you. You can't keep like pushing them away and giving them nothing.
Yes.
Because you're not going to get better.
Yeah.
Because then it follows up with the next line, is it insensitive for me to say, get your shit together so I can love you?
Yes.
So long story short.
I know.
Yeah.
message
is the same as before.
Yes, it is.
Except before she said, if I would have known how many pieces you had crumbled into. And in the bridge she says, if I would have known how sharp the pieces were you'd crumble into.
I love that. That small detail in changing that lyric really shows like where it progressed to, how bad it got, and just like completely changed the dynamic of that lyric. Oh my God, that was genius.
How sharp, how sharp. Yeah, that's a lot.
It's a lot to reuse that lyric and then it's change that one bit. I can't handle that.
It's a lot.
I bridge. Sad ass lyrics over a bit of a bop. I'm just gonna say
over a bop. 100%. Yeah.
She's tricking us with that sound. 100%. Yeah.
Also, I feel like I'm actually quite enjoying that it's like one of those songs where she actually doesn't give you heaps of new information because like the verses are very similar and the rest, the bridge is the same as a lyric we've already heard.
Yes.
And the choruses are all the same.
Yes. But you know, we love that dynamic because sometimes that's what's needed. Like repeating that first lyric and changing it to sharp is a game changer as well in like the story progression and just like how she's feeling in general. We don't need a whole lot of new information.
I like it.
Yeah.
I like it. Sometimes it's overwhelming to have, I mean like my favorite Taylor Swift songs are the ones where she changes it 10,000 times and adds on three bridges and like Ivy, hello.
Yeah.
Ugh. But like, it's also like less overwhelming to have a song where she doesn't give you heaps of information and just like really emphasizes the important points that she has. But she has like, she didn't need to add any more lyrics to that song.
No.
Because we get the point. Like we get the picture. It like, perfect.
Yeah, you know, it's cool because like at the end there, they're kind of like mixing.
He's repeating the chorus, but he's saying different lines at the same time as she's saying another line.
Yes, yes.
So they're both singing the chorus, like just different chorus just different then parts of it.
Yeah.
Hello, there is a whole nother Taylor Swift song that's going to be on this album too that we get to react to, which is a lot.
Okay.
Oh my God. That was
a masterpiece, a whole new thing that we've never heard before. A whole new concept. Thank you so much. It's relatable. It's excellent. It's perfect. It's depressing. It's track five energy. It's destroying.
It's depressing.
It's just depressing in like a relatable way. So you're like, thank you for seeing me and hearing me and just like hearing this whole conversation and this topic. And like, once again, just like putting things into words that I would never be able to comprehend. She's so amazing. Oh my God. This time last year, we didn't have folklore yet. We were almost about to get it.
Literally this time last year, we had no idea what was coming for us.
We had no idea any of this was coming for us.
We had no idea. We didn't know who Aaron Dessner was.
No.
And I, never in my wildest dreams, intentional, never in my wildest dreams, would have thought that Bonniver and Taylor Swift would be working together on multiple occasions.
No.
Actually too much. I can't. The world. Bitch. And she'd be writing songs with Joe. Oh my God. No.
Our entire universe has changed within a year because we've gotten Folklore, Evermore, all of this collaborative.
We've got a fearless re-recording and all the songs that came with that. We got a fucking Haim feature. And then Haim featured Taylor Swift too.
We've been so well fed that it's actually kind of like,
I'm so full. Like I actually need, like I'm getting to that
point. Do you think I have digested anything? I am completely undigested.
I am constipated with Taylor Swift's music. Like I need to stop.
That's why she literally said, bitches, I'm giving you ready November so you can fucking rest.
Literally, thank you.
She's like, I know what's
best. But
also
I don't believe her. Have we spoken about that on camera, by the way? Oh my God.
By the way,
let's talk about the fact that we had a full mental breakdown about the Red re-recording in our 1989 video and then she announced it. Hello?
And we like 2 days after we uploaded that we were getting 1989 next. I think we all were, but like,
I think we all were convinced.
Well, I'm still really confused at what happened there. Like, I'm not 100% convinced that this has all been planned perfectly. Like, I think that something's happened because it's unlike her to be so...
Well, last night we were talking about her possibly being pregnant.
Oh, don't. I can't be doing that.
I can't deal with the Taylor Swift child in this world.
No, that's...
But also I can, like, please get pregnant.
No, but I don't... I'm not fully subscribing to that. I don't think she's pregnant. But I do think something's happened because I feel like maybe we're meant to get 1989 in the summer. Well, your summer.
Yeah, your summer. Your summer. Like, everyone watching is from the Northern Hemisphere. Your summer. We're the only two people that have winter right now. So sorry,
I can't believe Red is next. We were so unwell. We actually just had a mental breakdown over the fact that we're not going to survive. And, like, what do you mean? What do you mean we're getting 10 new songs?
And the 10-minute version of All Too Well. Oh, my God, are we going to get Better Man? I simply yes. will pass away if we get Better Man.
Yes, so we really want Better Man to be one of the Vault songs. We definitely getting the 10-minute... She actually needed to confirm that because...
No, she did. I'm glad that she did.
...need months to process that
information. I agree.
I think we would have... If she just announced it and we yes. had to react to it in the same day, I yes. don't think we would have survived.
I completely agree. Yeah. Also, while we're here having this conversation, I would love you guys to put in the comments maybe some, like... unreleased songs that you guys know that you think could be on Red, because Red's a funny one because I feel like a lot of the unreleased songs that we did know and do have are more placed in those like first three albums.
Yes.
Not a lot of them timing wise would be by the time Red came out, she was so big
that she'd stop doing that.
And she wasn't like, it was a bit more secure.
It was a bit more secure.
But my personal opinion is that we may get Battle. I think a lot of people know Battle. Yes, so I think we might be getting Battle as a Red Vault song, which is simply overwhelming.
If we get Battle and Better Man, R.I.P.
Yeah.
But also, like, it's so exciting for that reason because we probably don't know a lot of the songs that she's going to put on
yes,
there.
Which I like too. Speak Now, I think we'll get something like Permanent Marker.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then, like, on debut, like, we're obviously getting I'd Lie. She simply cannot be doing anything.
I'm actually unless she puts so I'd Lie on fucking there. Excited for debut. I am
so high-key excited for debut. Debut?
The thing is, like, people with new vocals.
Wait, let's actually talk about this for a second. No one's talking about debut re-recording.
No.
And no one talks about debut in general. Do you know how many fucking iconic songs are on this?
So
our
many.
Song, Teardrops on My Guitar.
Should've Said No.
Should've Said No.
Oh my
Picture
God.
To Burn. Tim McGraw. Oh, Hello? Oh I've already God. Said five and I'm already fucking
I'm
you up.
So
Do you know how many fucking good songs are on that
Cold
album?
Cold As You. Guys, can you believe we're experiencing this? It's actually the best thing to ever happen.
Personally,
to the
I cannot
universe.
Believe that we're experiencing this. Like what? Taylor Swift really said... I love you.
I can't believe we're getting Red next. I actually do hope that there's nothing else in between Red because, like I said, need time to process.
Same.
Need time
she
to
can
process.
Do other random things like this.
Yeah, but please.
But
don't
drop a surprise
album.
I simply can't do another surprise album. Like
I don't think we will think because she was very clear with her words. She
yes.
says my next album is going to be Red Taylor's version. On the 19th of November, and like I've read those words over and over again just to see
there's a reason she worded it like that.
Yeah.
There's a reason she worded it like that.
She could have just said 100% Taylor's version.
She could surprise us with things in the meantime, but I don't think it's a full album unless it's fucking TS10, and in which case I'm simply gonna die because
she said my next album.
No, she said my next re-record.
No, she said my next album.
Did she?
I've checked that because I've thought about that. If she could, she says my next
the
album.
The next album I'll be releasing is my version
very
of Red.
Specific,
okay,
T,
yeah,
very
cool.
Specific.
Yep, thank you. Good. I'm glad. I'm actually glad. I think we've had the conversation on camera before about the fact that she can't submit the re-records for albums for Album of the Year or for Grammys and stuff, but she can submit new songs.
Yes.
And here's the thing. Imagine if she submitted All Too Well 10-minute version. And it won, like, best record or song or whatever it is. That's deserved.
That would be so iconic.
That is deserved.
Yeah, and because everyone, like, everyone agrees it's her best song. Like,
yeah.
like critically. Like,
yeah.
All Too Well is, like, critically acclaimed Taylor Swift's best song. Like, so, like, where's the Grammy?
Anyways, thank you so much for watching.
We're overwhelmed.
So blessed that we have a new Taylor Swift song.
Yeah. To be listening to for the
please
rest of the
discuss in the comments all the things that we have also been discussing in this video.
Yeah, and if there's
need any, opinions,
oh my God.
Need thoughts,
do you know what
need
my,
facts.
My, one of my favorite things on the planet, and you will agree, is just learning a new Taylor Swift song.
Oh, There's nothing better.
There's so much better. I don't know about this song yet.
There's so much I don't know about this song yet.
And, like, that's what's frustrating sometimes when we react. Like, I'm editing afterwards. I'm like, oh, I didn't fucking say this.
Right?
But, oh my God. You just can't absorb it all. You just cannot absorb it all. But that's exactly why we do the breakdown.
That's exactly why we do the breakdown. Because
we react and then we have it for a few months.
That's true.
And then we come back to it and we're like,
this. There's so much we didn't say.
Yeah.
And also, actually, I'm not going to go there. Because it's about our Evermore breakdown and we haven't uploaded it yet. Yeah, so you've got a lot of content coming.
Yes.
Is what we're saying.
Okay, guys. Thank you so much for watching. And we'll see you again soon for God knows what.
Who the fuck knows, honestly. God. Okay, bye.